So Pokemon kind of look like real life animals. So today we're gonna be looking at videos of real life animals and trying to guess what Pokemon they're most like. If I get it right, I'll be able to keep the Pokemon. All right, well, we're starting out with a bunny, except it's not really a bunny. It looks like maybe like a combination of a bunny and a guinea pig and maybe a rabbit. Are a bunny and a rabbit the same thing? I'm pretty sure they are. Okay, so it's definitely a small rodent Pokemon. All right, what's a rodent Pokemon? There's like Rattata. There's Pikachu. It might be Pichu. It has a really long tail though, and it also has really pointy ears. Okay, I think I have a guess. You guys have to play along with me, so comment down below what you think this actual animal is in the Pokemon world. I'm going with Pikachu. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. If I get it right, I'll be able to keep the Pokemon. So let's try it out. If we go inside. Yes, I got it. I knew it was Pikachu. And now we actually added a Pikachu to our Pokemon army. Pika Pika. Look at this. This is so cute. By the way, you guys can actually get all the Pokemon that you'll see in today's video. In the description, I'm going to leave all the information that you need in order to join my Pixelmon server. Or you can just download the Pixelmon mod, go to multiplayer, and then add the server play.anubismc.com. Once you do that, just click on join the server, run all the way over here to Oasis, right click, and then you'll be able to start capturing all of the Pokemon that you see in today's video. Oh, okay, this is Toucan Sam. Well, it's not technically Toucan Sam, but it's a toucan. Ah, crap, dude, crap. What is the Pokemon called that looks just like a toucan? I'm pretty sure it has this like a very similar name. It's like Toucanon, Toucanon. That's my final guess, Toucanon. Come on. What the heck? Okay. Did I get it right? Let's right click. Yes, we did. Toucanon. Bro, the creators of Pokemon really just copied a toucan and made it into a Pokemon. It doesn't look like anything else other than a toucan. They just said copy and paste. Oh my God, this is the cutest thing ever. Look at it, it's so tiny. It's okay. I'm pretty sure this in real life is called a fennec fox. It's like one of the world's smallest species of fox. And it literally just looks like a tiny little puppy with ginormous ears. And I want one. But okay, what Pokemon is it? It could be a lot of different Pokemon, honestly. I'm trying to think of a Pokemon that has giant ears. It could be like a Vulpix. It could be an Eevee. It could be a Fennekin. I don't think it would be Delphox or Ninetales since those are bigger fox-like Pokemon. So it's either probably like Vulpix, Eevee, or Fennekin. Fennekin is like directly just a fox. So if I had to go with my best guess, it's going to be Fennekin. I don't know if that's right. Let's go find out. Behind door number 3. I am so talented. It's a Fennekin. But we are 3 for 3. If you guys think I'll get all of them today, please go smash like. Number 4 is literally just 2 birds. There are so many different bird Pokemon. I'm not gonna get this, guys. I'm freaking out. It could be any variation of a Pidgey, a Pidgeot, a Pidgeotto, maybe even like a Torchic. I'm trying to think if there's any bird that has lots of colors like these two birds. I think an Archon has lots of different colors, but at the same time, I don't know. There's just so many different types of birds that like, I don't think I'm going to get this one, even if I guess it like maybe a little bit correctly. There's just way too many options. Wait a second. My brain is working. The gears are turning. And I remember that there's one bird that has lots more colors than the birds that I'm thinking of. You see, I was going to guess a Pidgey, but I honestly don't think a Pidgey would have this many colors. It's like a Chatoot. Chatot. Okay. That's my final guess. Chatot.
All right. Let's see what's behind door number 4.
No way. Wait, is this a Chatot?
I am a Pokemon guessing god.
That's actually pretty impressive. You guys should probably subscribe and leave a like if you haven't already. I'm doing way better than I thought I would.
Oh, I know what this Pokemon is. I know exactly what it looks like in my brain, but I can't think of the name. It looks just like this. It's honestly unreal to think how many Pokemon have been just copied from real life creatures.
All right, well, this is getting a little bit weird. The fish are just kissing it. I don't know, man. It looks awfully strange. I don't like it.
What are they doing to each other? I didn't realize fish kissed. Are they like feeding each other? Are they fighting? Is this how they fight? There's different colors too.
So okay, there's a giant fish Pokemon, right? That's like a big fish and it has like massive cheeks and huge lips. What is it called? There's like Goldeen, there's Horsea, there's Magikarp, Sharpedo, Huntail, Wailord, but these are all not the fish that have the massive lips. I have no idea. My final guess is a Pokemon called Fish Lips.
No, it's a Pokemon called Love Disc. Look at it go. Yo, it's actually kind of vibing. Look at it swimming back left and right.
Sorry, Love Disc. I do not get to add you to my team because my brain is tiny.
Oh, no. What am I looking at right now? Okay, it's some sort of like sea snail or sea slug. We know that. And it comes in a lot of different variations. It might be a Shellos. possibly. That's one guess.
There's also Slugma, but Slugma isn't really known for being underwater. It's kind of like on fire, so it's probably not a Slugma.
Isn't there like a upgraded version, like an evolved version called a Gastrodon? That one I'm pretty sure has a shell. These ones don't have any shells, so it's probably not a Gastrodon.
Okay, my final guess is a Shellos. That one makes the most sense in my mind. I'm pretty sure they can come in different colors, but they're mainly pink, and I don't even know what we're looking at anymore. So before it gets too weird, we're gonna knock down this door, and it better be a Shellos.
Oh, yo! We got it!
That is sweet! It's so tiny! An Emolga.
It was an Emolga! Let's go!
I am doing so well today! Look at this little thing!
Like, it could be a Pidove, maybe a Pidgey, maybe even a Starly, if we're getting a little bit creative here.
I know that a Staraptor has like the little tail bush at the end of its tail where it kind of just like floops up. So I'm gonna go and guess Staraptor. I don't think it's right at all because this thing has so many colors and a Staraptor is basically like black and white.
But let's see what's behind door number 11. What the heck?
Oh no! It's an Unfezant! It wasn't a peacock we were looking at. It was a pheasant the entire time. I should have known.
Sorry, Unfezant. I'm not able to add you to my team. I'm so sorry. I'm dumb.
Number 13 is an axolotl Pokemon. Or just a Pokemon that looks like an axolotl.
What Pokemon looks like an axolotl?
I don't know. There are so many fishies.
I can't guess just one.
There's a lantern, which is like a lantern fish. A quillfish, which is basically just like a puffer fish in real life. A Magikarp is an actual fish. So we're not looking for like a fish Pokemon. We're looking for more of like a salamander Pokemon that's able to go in water and also on land.
I think I know what it is. I'm going with the Mudkip.
A Mudkip is a type of salamander, right? I don't know if it's based on an axolotl, but we're gonna find out.
Mudkip. No! What? Bro, a Mudkip looks way more like an axolotl than this.
Actually, it does kind of make sense. An axolotl has these horns coming out of its head that have the little tiny spines coming out, just like the Wooper does. So I understand why a Wooper is in there, but honestly, tell me a Mudkip does not look like an axolotl.
We need to make up for that last one because my internal brain is kind of a little bit disappointed in myself for not getting it.
What is that slimy salamander? That's not a Mudkip, is it?
Yo, it's my guy Coyote Peterson.
So I've been thinking about this for a long time, and the only lizard or like salamander Pokemon I can think of is a Dratini.
A Dratini is more of like an eel, but it's the only one I can think of. So that's my final answer, Dratini.
I don't have a good feeling about this.
Are you kidding me?
It was a Charmander?
No, 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 no. We're gonna act like we didn't see that one. That looks nothing like the salamander that we just looked at.
What is that? Oh, a seahorse. A Horsea. Boom, easy. I don't even need extra time.
Horsea, yeah, that one was easy.
Bro, why do its eyes look so scary?
Yo, we got it.
Well, that one was probably the quickest one that I actually figured out.
Analysis, we're looking at a bird and it's blue.
That's an Articuno, right?
That has to be a flipping Articuno. If it's not an Articuno, I'm gonna be butthurt.
Come on, Articuno. Yes, I knew that one right off the bat.
I think that's our first legendary that we've actually found the real life counterpart to.
Bro, it looks so majestical.
I don't really know how I feel about this. We're just gonna like go and we're gonna break this. That is not a Caterpie.
What is this thing? Oh, it's a Scolipede. How did I forget it's a Scolipede? Why am I dumb?
Who the heck is this guy? All right, what Pokemon looks like a goldfish? Magikarp. It's totally a Magikarp.
There better be a Magikarp behind it.
It was a Goldar! Why?
I should have guessed they were too fancy to be a Magikarp. It was a Goldeen.
Sorry, Goldeen. I can't add you to the ultimate Pokemon real life party. So sad.
Castle landed?
No! It was a Heliosisk!
The Heliolisk looks so cool.
I can't believe I got that wrong. Wait, it actually has the frill around the neck too. I can't believe I forgot about that.
Make sure you guys consider subscribing if you haven't already, and also leave a like. If today's video hits 10,000, we'll do another episode of this.